अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू ग्लोबल पब्लिक स्कूल ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टार्टेड अ न्यू लेसन दैट्स अवर इंडियन क्लाइमेट एंड वी आल्सो टॉक्ड अबाउट व्हाट इज द रीजंस बिहाइंड द क्लाइमेट चेंजेस इन इंडिया। दैट्स बिकॉज ऑफ द सी लेवल, दैट्स बिकॉज ऑफ द विंड्स विच ब्लो, ऑल दैट वी टॉक्ड अबाउट। एंड वी आल्सो टॉक्ड अबाउट सम ऑफ द सीजंस ऑफ इंडिया, दैट्स द समर सीजन, विंटर सीजन, and we also talked about rainy season and the retreating monsoon season. In our previous class we had a detailed discussion about the winter season and the summer season, and also the rain which falls in the summer season. What are we going to call that rain, name of the rain, all that we studied in our previous class. In this class of today we are going to talk about the different topic, that is the rainy season. So students, very simple, rainy seasons means we all know the rain will fall in that season. Yes, you guys are always correct. See, the thing is, this season is also known as the southwest monsoon season. You might be asking, ma'am, why do we call that, ma'am? See students, this season is also known as the southwest monsoon season because the temperature rises in the summer. We all know that the temperature rises in the summer because of the low pressure, because of which the low pressure is developed over the central part of India. Okay. On the other hand, the high pressure over the Indian Ocean will be created. Okay. So that's why the moisture, what happened? The wind blows. I think we learnt right in the earlier class. The wind blows from the Indian Ocean to India and then India to Indian Ocean. Because of that also the climatic changes happen. So that comes here, students. Hence the moisture laden wind blow from the southwest towards to India. So that's why the rain will be happening here. The next here is, students, about 75% of the rainfall which happens during the season. We know that hardly a 2% of rainfalls which happens in the winter season, and apart from in the summer season also some part of the rain will happen. But here in India, in the rainy season, 75% of the rainfall which happens during this season because the wind blows from the Indian Ocean to India. The next season coming up here is the retreating monsoon season. See, by the end of October and the southwest monsoon wind starts retreating. You might be asking, ma'am, why it will happen? See, you can see the date wise, students. 15th July, how the wind blows, and 1st July, how it blows, and June, 5th June, 10th June, how exactly the during June time the wind blows, all that it's been given here. There is an increase in the pressure and decrease in the temperature is the main reason for the retreating monsoon. What happened here is the pressure will increase and the temperature will keep on decrease, because of which the retreating monsoon winds by the end of October will start here. The tropical cyclones will be frequently acquired during this period, students. Please to remember this point. The tropical cyclones frequently occur in the Bay of Bengal during this season, and they cause some damage along with the east coast. We all know that there is a lot of issues which is happening because of the retreating monsoon season. You can see here what exactly the reason behind this. See how what exactly happens because of the wind blows and because of the cyclones and because of the floods. You can see the images here. And we are going to now talk about the annual distribution of rainfall in India. The first thing is, on the basis of the rainfall in India, it can be divided into three types. One is areas with low rainfall, and the second one is areas with a medium rainfall, and the third one is areas with a heavy rainfall. Based on the amount of rainfall which happens in India, it's been divided into three parts: one with a low rainfall, medium rainfall, heavy rainfall. So here, students, the next thing what we're going to learn here is areas with low rainfall means what? less than 50 centimeters of the rain which happens here. You can see here, Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan, I mean the desert places. It includes the Western Kutch, Thar Desert of Rajasthan and its adjoining areas like Western Punjab, Haryana, Gujarat of Zaskar range, all these places where it's a desert place where the rainfall is very less than 50 centimeters of rainfall, that places we call it as the distribution of low rainfall, areas with the low rainfall. Next comes up here is the which is the least rainfall receiving area. So Roorli in Jaisalmer of Rajasthan, you can see exactly where it comes. Please to remember, they can ask in the map also which is the low rainfall area in India. So it's a Roorli which is there in Rajasthan, Jaisalmer of Rajasthan. It receives the lowest amount of rainfall, that's just of 80.3 centimeter rainfall in India for a whole year. It is the driest place in India. You can see the image here. It is the driest place in India. The next, the rainfall which is average. It is a long belt extending from northern Punjab to Cape of Kanyakumari. Here it's a medium rainfall normally. It is a broader in the north and narrower in the peninsula. So between Western Ghats to Eastern Ghats, that's why here it receives a average rainfall. For example, average rainfall means 50 to 100 centimeters. It's not beyond that. Okay. So its areas with a medium rainfall means 50 to 100 centimeters because it's very broader in the north and narrower in the peninsular places. So that's why here it is a medium rainfall. It's not high, it's not low also. And areas with a heavy rainfall, it is 100 to 250 centimeters. It is found in four separate belts. Belts you can see here. A narrow belt in Western Ghat. A belt from Jammu Hills through the Himachal Pradesh here. Next, northeastern India. Next, west, northeastern India here. And the west side of Western Ghats. So these are the places. And Maison Ram, students, this is a definite question for you, 1 mark question. And this is a definite answer for you, 1 mark question. And it can be asked for your map also. Maison Ram, which is located in this zone, gets the heaviest rainfall in India. Maison Ram is a village where it receives the highest rainfall in India. You can see the map which actually the location popping up here. The heaviest rainfall which will happen, 100 to 250 centimeters of rainfall which will be there. So that's all about this lesson, students. I want you to read this lesson, revise this lesson, and if you have any doubts, please send it through the Google Classroom app and please write your explanatory notes of this lesson. If you have any doubts, please reach out to me at any point of time. And the notes of this lesson, I'll be sharing it to you in the next class of ours. Till then, stay safe, stay home, and keep your learning button on, students. Thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.